Hello everyone and welcome back to the Data Structures and Algorithms course. The topic for today's lecture is heaps. So what are heaps? So heaps are an important type of tree data structure. So we have already looked at what are trees. So heap is also a special kind of trees. And what is special about them? So we will implement these using arrays. So initially in the previous lectures we made trees using linked lists, but for heaps we'll use arrays. And heaps also we'll look at binary heaps, the case in which each parent has two children. So we'll look at binary heaps. So this is an example of heaps. So the definition of a heap is that the parent node has a value which is less than its children, or the opposite. So in this case it is that the value stored in a node is less than the value stored in each of its children. So you can see that 4 here is less than 7 and 11. So like in binary search tree, we had that the node should be greater than the left child and less than the right child. In this case it should be less than both these children. So this is considered a min heap, because the root node is the minimum, and then as we go down the tree the value keeps increasing. There is also a version called as max heap, in which it is opposite. So the value stored in node would be greater than the value stored in each of its children. So we'll just consider minimum heap for now. So you can see that the left subtree and right subtree are not related to each other at all. So it's just that 7 is greater than 4 and 11 is greater than 4. After that, there could be anything in these trees. So you can see for 7, we have 13, 71, 9. So you can see these are very different values, but they are all greater than 7. So they are all perfectly valid children for 7. Then you can see 9 has a children 21. So you can see that 71, although is greater than 21, it is coming before in the tree. So this is still valid. So this is not a binary tree, because for 7 we have 3 children. So this is just a normal heap. So that was the main definition of heap. So we look at min heaps. Value stored in each node should be less than the value at a value of its children. So we'll now discuss what are the operations that we can perform on a heap. So the query operation is find a minimum. So it reports us the smallest key stored in the heap. So for a minimum heap, this is very simple. So we just print out the value which is in the root node. So that is one operation we can do, find min. Then we have some update operation. So for that we have to modify our heap. Okay, so this is our heap. So if we are performing some, we have to perform some actions on it, so, and modify it according to it. So first of all is a create heap h. So we have to create an empty heap h. So this is just a, you can say we are instantiating a variable h which is a heap. Then we have insert x in h. So insert a new key value, so insert a new node which has value x into the heap, already existing heap, which is h. So this is another function. Then we have extract minimum. So here we just printing out the value, but here we are deleting the value, smallest value from h. So we will remove 4 from here, but if we remove 4 from here, then we have to modify our tree such that we have a new root node. So we have to perform some modification to this in the resultant tree, and such that it still remains a heap. That is extract minimum. Then we have decrease key p delta n h. So what does this do? We have to decrease the value of key p, so the node which has value p, we have to decrease that value by delta, amount delta in heap h. So let's say we had to decrease the value of this node 21 by 12, so let's say 13. So now if we subtract this, if we subtract 13 from 21, we result in 8, but then 8 would be less than 9. So that will make it that the heap condition is not followed. So we have to change it, modify our heap in such a way that the new value also fits in heap. So in that case, we'll have to swap 8 and 9. So such that the new heap, such that it still remains a heap. Sorry. So that is decrease key. Then the last function, one of the main functions, is merge. So we have two heaps, H1 and another heap H2. So we simply merge these two heaps into a single heap. So these are the main operations that we perform on a heap. So can we implement a binary tree using an array? So this is yes, and we will do so in heap. So in some special cases we can. So we discussed what is a complete binary tree in our previous lecture. So here we come back to complete binary tree. So what was it again? So we complete the tree in top to down, and then in the last level we go from left to right. So in a complete binary tree of 12 nodes, it would look like this. So we start from top. It would be first node is this, then this, then this, then 1, 2, 3, 4, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 12 nodes are finished. So our complete binary tree will look like this. So here we have levels, level 0, and it has node 1, 2 to the power 0. Then we have level 1, which has 2 nodes, 2 to the power 1. Then we have level 3, which has, sorry, level 2, which has 4 nodes, 2 to the power 2. Then level 3 would have maximum of 2 to the power 3 nodes, which is 8, but in this case there are only 5 nodes. So we can see that we can fill 3 more nodes. If we had 3 more nodes, then we can fill it in this level also. So these are some relations that are very important. So let's look at them. So the label of the leftmost node at level I, leftmost node at level I, so it is 2 to the power I minus 1. So for level 0, it is 2 to the power 0, which is 1, minus 1, so 0. So index is 0. Then for this is level 1, it is 2 to the power 1, which is 2, minus 1, which is 1 again. So this is index 1. Then for level 2, we have 2 to the power 2 minus 1, which is 4 minus 1, so 3. So if you can see that the index of the very first node of each level is 2 to the power I minus 1, where I is the level of that node. Yeah, so then we have the it is a little bit of misprint here, but it is saying that the label of node V at level I, which is K from the left. So what will be that? So that means that, let's say for 4, we are saying that the label of node V, the node 4, which is at level number 2, which is K distance from the left. So it is sec 2 from the left, because 3 comes first, then comes 4. For that, the formula would be 2 to the power I plus K minus 2. So for 4, we can apply that formula. So it is 2 to the power I, so 2 to the power 2 is 4, plus K, which would be 2 in this case. So 4 plus 2 is 6, minus 2, which is 4. This will give us the node value as 4. Then for 5, everything else would be the same, but the K value would be 3. So the final answer would be 5. Then this for 6, K value would be 4. So the answer would be 6. So that was the label of a node V, which is at level I, which is K distance from the left, Kth node from the left of that level. Then comes the label of the left child of V, which is this formula. So if you try to apply this here, let's say for 9, let's say we have our base node as 4. So if you want to check for the left child of it, so for 4, value of I is 2, and the value of K is 2 again. So if you try to fill it, then it would be 2 to the power 2 plus 1 minus 1 plus 2 bracket 2 minus 1. So 2 to the power 3, 8 minus 1, 7 plus 2, which would be 9. So that left child is 9. And for the right child, it is this formula. So 2 to the power I plus 2k minus 2. So if we do the same again here, so it would be 2 to the power 3, which would be 8 plus 2 into 2, so 4. So 8 plus 4 is 12, minus 2 is 10. So you can check it for any node here. So just keep in mind what is I and what is K. So if we use these formulas, then we can get the label of the left child and right child. So these are the formula you can use, but we don't really use them. The main are V formula. So if we come to this, we have V be a node with label J. So V could be any node. Then the left label of the left child of V would be 2 into J plus 1. And the label of the right child would be 2 to the power J plus 2. So if we for node 4 here, the value is 4. And then the left child would be 2 into 4, 8 plus 1, which is 9. And the right child would be 2 into 4 plus 2, which is 10. So this is much more even simpler, and also we will use this formula much more. but then there's also this formula of label of the parent. So again, let's say we are at 4. So what is the parent of 4? So for that, we have the floor function. So floor function, this you can see this special type of brackets where there is a little bit of, you can say, dash in the bottom and both of these lines. So this is floor function. So floor function of j minus 1 divided by 2. So if you put 4 in here, so it would be 4 minus 1, 3 divided by 2. So that would be 1.5. So since we are taking the floor function of it, we remove the 0.5 and we get 1. So we get 1, which is this function. And then if we add for 3 also, if we apply the same, so it will be 3 minus 1, 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1 again. So we get the parent. So these are simpler formulas and we will be using them in our function. So let's look at this example. So a completely binary and an array. So here is an array. These are the labels, and above these are the values which we are storing in that node. So we have a question here. So what is the relation between a complete binary and an array? So a complete binary can be implemented by an array. So that is the relation. A complete binary is implemented by an array, which can look like somewhat like this. So again, these are the labels at the bottom. So this is node 0, 1, 2, up until 11, and these are the values. So here this is not a heap, because as you can see, the values are not the properties are not being satisfied. So 41 is greater than 17, but then again this 17 is less than 57. So this is just a normal comp and this is just an ordinary complete binary. It is not a heap, but it is an array implementation. So it is also the most compact representation. So let's come to binary heap. So here is an example of a binary heap. So using an array. So we had all these nodes. So if we just label them again 0, 1, 2 up until 11, we can see and then these would be the values in the array. So this would be 4, then 14, then 9, followed by 17, 23, 21, up until 33. So this is an array representation of a binary heap. So here is the implementation of binary heap. So n, then we keep h. So h is the heap, which is heap array. So it is an array which is of size n, used for storing the binary heap. So n is the total number of nodes we have here. So in this case, n is 12. So h is the name of our array we will use. And then we have size, which is a variable which stores the total number of keys currently in the heap, which is was n. So size is 12. So first of all, the function we had, which was find min. So this was simple. So we just print out the first value in our array, so which is index 0, h of 0. So since the indexing of an array starts from 0, we have 0, 1, 2, up until 11. So we know that this is a min heap. The smallest value would be the one at the bottom, because we know that the left and right children both have larger values than this, and then the children of those would have larger values than even and the children of 4. So we know that 91 would be greater than 4. So we simply print out h of 0 and we get the minimum. So then we have a slightly more difficult one, which is we have to remove this 4, which is extract minimum function. So we have to somehow remove this 4, and then we have to modify our tree, sorry, modify our array. We are looking at it as an array, so we have to modify it somehow such that it is still a heap. So first of all, what we will do is, since after deleting 4, the total size would become 11 instead of 12. And we know that for array representation, it would be from 0 to 10 now. So this node should be blank. So what we do is we just move the last node of our array, which is 33 in this case, and we move it, override it, we override the first node with that value. So since we are removing 4, we just simply override 4 with value 33, and we make this as blank. So it will look something like this now. And then from this here, we can just we can just swap at each stage and go up until the child. So we check from 33, we check its both of its children, so 14 and 9 both are its children. So we see that 9 is the smallest among all three. So we swap 9 to here because we know that 9 would be less than 14 as well as 13. So if we just swap both of these, then it will, and then our tree would be satisfied at this stage. If we do so, we swap 33 and 9. And how do we do so? We use these formulas using for the left child and the right child. We know that j initially would be 0 as this is the root node, and then using this formula we can check for the left child and the right child back, and we can swap if the value is greater. So we swap with 9 would be the right child. Then since we did not change anything from the left, so we can now ignore all the left part. So we'll now have to check for the right subtree right now. So for 33, we are now swapping. We check again for both of its children using the 2j plus 1 and 2j plus 2 formula. We check again from these three values. We know that 21 is the smallest. So we can swap 33 with 21. So we do so. It will look something like this, and now 33 has no more children. So we can say that it is a completely friendly, so it is a completely fine heap. So our conditions are satisfied at each and every node. So this is how we do so, and it takes order of log n time. Why? Because we are making the number of traversions are log n, which is the height of the tree, which is at the worst case we are traveling the entire tree. So we could have gone from here to 14 to 23 to 25, which would be height of 4. So this is the time complexity for extracting it. So then we have function which is insert x of h. So we have to insert a value or insert a node of value x into our heap of already existing heap h. So let's say this is a new heap and we have to insert value 11. So we just first of all insert the value at the last node here. So newest node. So 11 is put in here according to the complete binary tree. Yeah, so it is put here according to the complete binary tree. And then we recursively check up for the parent. So here we have 11, we check with its parent. The parent formula using the floor function of j minus 1 by 2. So we check with 11 and 25. We check, so 25 is greater than 11 in this case. So we can swap them. So we swap. Then we check 11 with 23, new parent. Again, we see that 23 is larger than 11. So we can swap them. Then we check for 14. So we swap them. And then finally, we check with 9. This is valid since 11 is larger than 9, which is which follows the criteria for the heap. So this is fine and we can leave it here. So this will be a resultant heap from this function. So that is how we use insert function. So we insert it at the last node wherever it is, and then we check for its parent up until we get to the condition where this where the heap property is satisfied. So if the node had value, let's say 7, so it would now then swap in 9 also. So 7 would become a root node. So that is so here is the function. So I index we put as the size of h. So that would be this value. So sorry, yeah. This value, so where we have to put 11, so that is I. Then we are updating, so h of the value of that node we are updating as x, the new value which we are putting, and then the size is incremented by 1. Then using this while loop, we are checking for this condition that I is greater than 0, so we don't have to check for the root node. So if we get to the root node, we know that it is perfectly fine. So we check for that, and we check for this parent condition. So if that node is less than its parent, so in that case we know that we have to swap. So we swap them, and then we update the value of I to the parent value. So then we can recursively check for the parent of that value. And if at a stage we let's say, so this was the final value. So if at stage we do not find that this value is less than 9, so this condition would become false and we can come out of the loop. So this is the insert function. The time complexity is again log n. Again, the height of the tree is log n. So we have to make at the worst case log n traverses, log n checks. So these are the remaining two functions which you can try. So decrease keep p delta h. So for that, what you have to do is you have to check, find the key p. Then we have to subtract that value with delta amount, and then again use then we can check sorry then again using the insert using this function of insert, we can recursively check for the parent until we satisfactorily place it in the position that satisfies our keep condition. So it is similar to insert, and it will also take order of log n time at worst case. Then we have the merge h1 and h2. So we have two heaps, h1 and h2, and we have to merge them. It will take order of log n time, where n is the total number of elements in h1 and h2. So we can compare both of these elements and then simply put one by one. So in array, so at node 0 we check for both if which one is less than which amongst the first nodes of h1 and h2 is less. So that would be the first node of our new heap. And then we can just check for both of these trees and put the minimum value at each case. So then we have a building of a bind tree. So if you want to build a bind tree incrementally, so if you want to build a tree one by one, so first you put value 9, then we put let's say 14, then we put 11, then 21, so something like that. So if you want to build something like this incrementally, so the time complexity would be order of log n. Why? Because we are basically what we are doing is we are doing these insert functions which takes order log n time n times. So for n nodes we are applying the same insert function. So insert 9, insert 14, insert 41, insert 32. So for all these n nodes we are applying that function which takes order of log n time each time. So the total time complexity would be order of log n. But what we can do is we can build a binary heap in order of n time also. So we look at how we can do that. So this was incremental building. So here we have a complete binary, and we know that the number of leaf nodes would be the ceiling function of n by 2. So if we count for this case, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the total nodes was 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So 20 divided by 2 would be 10, and the ceiling of 10 is 10. So if it was 21 nodes, then it would be 21 divided by 2, and then the ceiling would be 11. So in that case, it would be 11. The ceiling of n by 2 is the total number of leaf nodes in a complete binary tree. So this is the reasoning of order of n log n time, because we are using insert function n times. So that took us n log n time. So here it is. But we can now we can do the same thing. We can build a binary heap in order of n time. So how do we do so? We use the bottom-up approach, which looks something like this. So if let's say we have some random array here, so we are just putting values at any node. So what we will observe is that the heap property is satisfied at each of the leaf nodes. Why is that? Because none of these leaf nodes have any children. So since they have no children, then the greater than less than value of course does not make any sense. So it is being satisfied at these leaf nodes. So what we can do is simply if we skip these nodes and we just check for these remaining nodes, and we check for the check with its children and swap accordingly, then we can do so. Then we can build a heap much faster. So for heap property, every node must be smaller than its children. So here is the approach. We just copy the given n elements into an array. So in any order, first of all, then the heap property will hold for all leaf nodes in the corresponding complete bind tree. And then leaving all the leaf nodes or the remaining n by 2 nodes, which I think floor n by 2 nodes will be remaining. And then for that, we just process the elements in the decreasing order of their numbering and set the heap property for each of them. So for 25, we will check with the children, so we can swap 23 and 25. Then for 17, we will check, so we can swap 9 and 17. And then similarly, we can check up until the top. So this is the example. So the first non-leaf node, which is 25, so we check with the children. And we know that this has to be swapped. So we swap them. Then we check for the next nodes. This is 17. We know that 9 is smaller, so we swap these two. Then for this, we know that 47 is the smallest, so we swap these. And then we do so with all the nodes in this backwards order. So in the array, we just go from I to I minus 1, I minus 1, I minus 1. So just go in this, we just follow these arrows. So here is the case for 9 and 54. So we swap 9 and 54. Then for 54, we'll have to check, and then we can swap 17 and 54. Then 54 will be here. We will have to swap 37 and 54. Yeah, so that is how we updated at node V. So let V be the node corresponding to index I in H, and the process of restoring heap property at I is called heapify. So this restoration function is called as heapify at node I. So we performed it at 54, which was node number 1. So we look at what it will look like. So it will look like mainly this. So we set a variable n as, and we set its value as size of h minus 1. Then we create a flag, boolean flag, and set it as true. And then we make this while loop here with these two conditions. So I less than equal to floor of n minus 1 by 2. And flag is equal to true. And for each of these, we can set, we first of all set I min as I, and then if this is the case where h of I is greater than 2i plus 1, so h of I is greater than 2i plus 1, that means it is that the parent is greater than the left child. Then we know that the minimum value would be the left child, and then this second case is this one. So 2i plus 2 less than equal to n, and h min is greater than 2i plus 2. In this case, we can set a minimum value as the right child. And then we have, if min is not equal to i, that means that one of the children had a smaller value. So in that case, we can swap the children. We can swap the parent and children value, and then we can set I as the minimum value. So then recursively, sorry, using this while function, we can check for the child as also. So what we did again using this example, for 54 we check with both of its children. We found that 9 is the minimum amongst all three of these. Since 9 was not 54, we know that it was one of its children, so we swap it with its child. So we swap 9 and 54, and then we perform heapify at this left child, so which is this node, which will be 0, 1, 2, 3. So at node number 3, we perform heapify again. So for 54, 47, 17, 17 is the smallest. So we swap these two. Then we perform at this node, and then again here 37 was the smallest, so we swap, and up until we get to the up until this becomes the leaf node or our property is satisfied. So this was heapify function, and using this we can do the building of a binary heap in order of n time, because we're not using insert function, we are just modifying this. So this is the mathematical calculation why it is order log n. We don't have to pay much attention to this, but you can see why this is so. So now we'll discuss as how to sort using a binary heap. So for sorting, we can simply make a while loop, and with the condition that up until h has some values, so we can just extract min and then we can print out that value. So for, let's say, this, what we can do is we can simply print out the smallest value. So 90 would not be the smallest value in this case, so 9 would be the smallest value. We can print out that, so our tree would modify, and then the new root node would, we know that would be that, sorry, the new root node would be the smallest node. So we can then extract that. So we can use that continuously, and we can print that out in the order. So if it was a min heap, then we get our nodes in ascending order. If it was a max heap, then we get it in descending order. And the time complexity would be order of n log n. Why? Because each extract min takes order of log n time, and we are performing it for n nodes, since we are extracting all the nodes from the heap, which are total n. So it also takes n log n time, as just like merge sort and quick sort. So that was sorting using heap, and that was heaps in general. So we looked at how we create heaps and what are the various functions we perform in heap. So that was it for today's lecture, and we'll see you in the next lecture. So wishing you happy learning and goodbye.